Hello everyone, it's me Mukesh Thapa, third year student, currently studying at Kathmandu University, Department of Geomatics Engineering. Today I'm going to discuss about the photogrammetric process for the cadastral map preparation with the use of UAV images. So let's begin.
Here in the screen we can see the entire photogrammetric process for the cadastral map preparation with the help of UAV images. And now site selection. Primary work to begin any survey related work is site selection. After site selection, recce is done, during which the topography of the terrain, feasibility study, area covered, etc. are studied. Overall procedure and the budget estimation for the cadastral map are studied during this phase. After site selection and recce, ground control points are established throughout the area of which the cadastral map is going to be prepared. Ground control points can be established before or after the photography. Here we can see the number and the distribution pattern of the GCP. Minimum 3 GCPs are required for the orientation. Different studies suggest the use of 5 to 10 GCPs depending upon the topography of an area. Increases the number of GCP doesn't increase the accuracy, rather the competition would be difficult and lengthy. The difference between the pre-pointing and the post-pointing of the GCP is shown in the screen. After GCP establishment, selection of the UAV is necessary. The camera and the sensor fitted in the UAV must be good enough in order to meet the project goal. Also, the budget of the project should also be considered. Flight parameters such as flying height of an aircraft should be considered during flight. Entire photographs should be captured in the same flying height in order to obtain the constant scale of the photograph. Here in the screen, we can see the general calculation of the flying height in order to prepare the cadastral map of 1:1250 using the DJI Phantom 4 Pro with a camera focal length 0.024 meter. Once all the parameters are defined, flight is made and all the photos are captured. Lateral and the side overlap are made sufficient enough for the proper orthophoto generation. The captured photographs need proper orientation. In aerial triangulation, based on proper orientation, X, Y and Z ground coordinates of the individual points are determined. The principal application is in extending through a strip or block of the photo is known as bundle block adjustment, and in conventional rectification, a mathematical transformation is applied to rotate, warp, stretch a digital image to match a set of ground control points. After that, the orthomosaic is generated. Through orthophoto is geometrically correct over an entire image and the direct measurement can be made. Distortion due to relief and tilt are removed. With the production of the orthophoto, the entire images will be in the same scale. After that, the DTM is generated. A DTM is a mathematical representation of the ground surface, most often in the form of regular grid, in which a unique elevation value is assigned to each pixel. Generated DTM helps in the information extraction of the type, that is the terrain of the partials. After orthophoto and the DTM generation, digitization is carried out. On the generated orthophoto, objects which are to be shown on the cadastral map are such. The objects which are distinguishable, such as river, road, etc., are marked. After identifying the object of interest, parcel boundaries are identified in the true orthophoto. After identifying the boundaries of the parcels with the help of different surfaces like ArcGIS with parcel extension, digitization of the objects and the parcel boundaries are carried out. Once the field verification is done, cadastral map is start to prepare. Similarly, if the cadastral map is to be maintained in the digital environment, database containing the information of the land parcels, that is ownership, type of parcels, area cover, etc. are also recorded. After the database preparation, according to the objective, cadastral map is prepared either in the digital format or in the analog format. Cartographic techniques are used and the symbols are clearly mentioned during the cadastral map preparation. Finally, the prepared cadastral map is printed according to the requirements and distributed to the necessary parties. Digital cadastral map makes easier in parcel merging, parcel division, etc.
This is all about the cadastral map preparation with the help of UAV images. After watching this video, I hope everyone will understand something about the preparation of the cadastral map with the help of UAV images. Thank you.